Welcome back, guys. Game number two here in this best of three. The MSI Dragon Battle continues, and game number one was a little bit of a slow starter out from Big Red Machine. They didn't get the swing that they'd love to take down all the tier one towers and really push it towards Power Rangers. PR just held their own, made sure that they got farm on their core heroes, and there was nothing really that Screen Squad to do. This time around, though, they get General his Invoker. So, Arcade, take the Queen of Pain as their first pick, Winter Wyvern. Counted out there by Big Red Machine.
Reserve time.
Tiny Wisp. So Winter Wyvern, not a bad pick in the first phase, but Invoker for General. We've seen him do some amazing work with that. Power Rangers take out the Bane and the Earthshaker. Great setup heroes for the Tiny Wisp, Radiant, as well as the Invoker on top of all of that. Go with the Juggernaut again. Interesting stuff. Now, no Tusk, of course, for Screen this time around. No Nightstalker for him either. It'll be interesting to see what he actually goes for. I'm guessing Slander goes for the Wisp. They could, of course, switch things up a little bit if they so desire. But for those of you guys looking for the KP versus CIS Rejects game, that was postponed and it should be postponed over on Dota 2 Lounge as well soon.
5 seconds remaining.
That's not happening tonight. That got moved around a little bit. But MSI Dragon Battle here. This is the grand final. Game number two. Game number one went the way of Power Rangers, so this is make or break time for Big Red Machine. 1,500 euros for first place and 500 for second. So there's a decent chunk of change in between the two of them here, as they're thinking long and hard about this fourth pick for themselves. So Invoker, Tiny Io, Skywrath Mage is going to be the go-to hero. So a little more silence, a little more nuke power, but they are lacking heavily on stuns. Very limited on long-range initiation. Very limited on teamfight control and incredibly lacking in teamfight sustain. Whereas you look at Arcade, they've got Healing Ward, Cold Embrace, they've got big teamfight ulties in the Sonic Wave and the Winter's Curse, they've got good choke point abilities, and they've got good laning power. Broodmother dominates lanes, there's nothing really to stop her, nothing to slow her down.
5 seconds
remaining. I guess Power Rangers, they look to ban out something like the Darkseer as their final one. Darkseer, Bristleback, something along those lines. Maybe the Axe could be a potential as well. Axe is pretty annoying, but it's really hard to fit these in. A Bristleback, probably not what you're going to be looking for here. Axe would work just because the Berserker's Call adds you that extra bit of stun. Vacuum with the wall, go for a mech. Could add the synergy you need from Big Red Machine.
Dire team ban.
I think you ban the Axe. Yeah, that's the solid ban, definitely.
Radiant team pick.
So Power Rangers quad mid, Winter Wyvern Juggernaut top, Broodmother down towards the bottom lane. And I don't know. Dazzle's the last pick for Power Rangers, maybe. They're still lacking stuns themselves, so I think they need to pick themselves something that offers you that lockdown ability. Legion Commander going to be that Broodmother counter or pseudo counter. Anyway, for Big Red Machine, try and deal with the Mama. The Mama with the Spiderlings everywhere. Final pick for you. Witch Doctor, I think, would work decently. Witch Doctor's good against Tiny Wisp, offers you the stun, remaining. The sustain, the physical damage, and a little bit
Five
of laning power as well.
Remaining.
I think that could work out for them.
Reserve time.
What else could we be looking for? Ancient Apparition isn't too bad. Adds in another bit of team fight capability with the Ice Blast, but I think you do need some kind of guaranteed stun. Something a little more mobile as well. Shadow Shaman could work, but he's very slow on his feet. Helps with the push a little bit more, with the Serpent Wards getting thrown out here and there. But moving around and actually being active on the map is also something you've definitely got to look for. Vengeful Spirit? I still think Witch Doctor, Spirit Breaker, is that? That's banned out, so never mind. Sand King. Sand King could potentially work. A greedy Sand King pick, going to the jungle. Maybe roam around a little bit. Lina in the support role as well. That could be pretty nifty. But they're thinking long and hard about this one. Still not entirely sure where they're going to be heading into it. So 34 seconds remaining. And they go with the pick that I said the first time. I think it's the best all-round pick for them. You know, team fight sustain, good ultimate. It's just a Kask. Like, Kask is such a great ability up against Tiny Wisp, against anyone in general, you know. It's just irritating, annoying to deal with. And it's a way to cancel TPs. Because if you look at this big red machine, if they run themselves around and get into ballsy situations, and they want to just escape, they TP. Just TP. Because there were literally no stuns outside of that Winter's Curse from Power Rangers. So, yeah. That's a good way to go. That's a good way to go into this. So, game number two. I think I favor Power Rangers draft again here just because of the Broodmother. Like, you can talk about the teamfight capability. They've got laning power and stuff like that. Big Red Machine, they have Tiny Wisp. Interesting. Talking about a stand-in. And yeah, there was a name I didn't really recognize. This guy. What's this guy doing? Who's he? What's going on? Who was Axmo before? In the offlane. I don't know if they switched players or if he just changed his name. Oh well. Oh well. Well, Screen and ZXC. Gonna be a safe lane, Tiny Wisp here, it looks like. No bottle rush for Screen over on the Wisp. Slander, Scarath, Mage, ZXC on the Tiny. Moving towards mid as General with his Wex first invoker. There we go, standard stuff. Cheshire Cat, Broodmother for him. And Observer Ward, pretty early placement there. In that pull-through camp. So Slander can't really get his golden experience that he'd love. The Legion Commander. Nice little Observer Ward placed down there. J4. We could look to deward this already, but they're not entirely sure where this is. Web's been scouted out, but yeah. Legion up at top. Over on the dark side, J4 Witch Doctor. Tron again on the Juggernaut. Barash playing Queen of Pain. Big Nom, Winter Wyvern. Not any massive changes, really. Cheshire Cat, what the hell is this set? The Leper Mother. Look at that. It's got boils and red shit all over her. Not
the
looking too happy.
Begins.
Nice little icons, I've got to say. Nice little icons. Trade-off of Bounty Runes once again. And Big Nom. Oh, here we go. The Salve coming out to the Invoker. Now, are you gonna get this? Because we saw earlier today or yesterday. I can't remember. Time has, like, slipped by. I think it was last night. Sneaky. What a player. General, he knows it's coming. He knows the Winter Wyvern's up there or somewhere trying to snipe the courier. But I was going to say, we saw Seneko fail with the Phoenix trying to courier snipe. This time, it's going to fail because of General's extra bit of skill. It's going to get sniped on the way back. Big Nom. Two hits in. There we go. Courier dies. Take that one out. So defensive trial in here. ZXC Tiny Screen on the Wisp and Cheshire Cat being forced back a little bit. Sentry down from Slander. Cheshire Cat, this Arcane Bolt spam is going to be annoying. Super irritating. And how many sentries do we actually have here? Screen has two more. So Broodmother definitely in a world of hurt here. Can sentry? Can eat? Get it fast enough. I think he was expecting it to be a little bit further down, a little bit deeper, because that's where you'd expect it to be. If you place the sentry here, and you're preempting the second web to be placed in this area to get the double coverage, which he does now, actually. Preempting the double coverage, unless Cheshire Cat moves the web over to the side. But this is not easy for the Broodmother. But as we all know, Broodmother, as long as you can just sort of outlast the sentries and keep yourself alive, dying once, twice, three times, it doesn't matter that much. Because you'll always get gold, you'll get experience, and you'll bring yourself back into the lane. Oh, there we go. More sentries brought out. Cheshire Cat. Screen. Counters it out. Cheshire Cat, you're going to counter it again? Yep, there we go. It's just a battle of sentries. As Cheshire Cat will come out on top. The Broodmother wins. Fatality. There we have it. Cheshire Cat now has a lane. A lane that you can get experience from. For once. Barash at mid. 7-4, 5-5 for this General Invoker. And he's going to go for the phase boots, more likely than not. Quaswex build for General. He goes for the double blades of attack and then into the brown boots. Right now, he's going to take a shadow strike. 2 points in Quarth should mitigate a lot of this damage. In fact, completely nullify it. Down the bottom lane, we've got more sentries. Two more sentries. The battle continues. Slander, more tangos expended. More sentries. More! More, I say. This is so annoying. 18 last hits up on top lane, though. This Juggernaut is farming himself away. And the Legion Commander with only 3, but she's getting her levels in. Up to level 2 now. And the boots up as well. Hasn't died just yet. First blood yet to be spilt. Bloody hell, really? Really, Cheshire Cat? Orbs and sentries. And a Ring of Regen. So kill potential up on top lane. It's going to start actually getting tense up here for the Legion. With a cask. And that Splinter Blast. Level 2 spin up on the Juggernaut. You can bring down this Legion. Definitely. Definitely. Just need to time it. Barash at mid lane. He's going to start taking a pounding here from the Invoker. With the first blades of attack up. Cold Snap with the EMP. It gets annoying. Queen of Pain is just going to get harassed down little by little. Chipped away. Let's get the boots and needs to start controlling these runes a little bit more. Legion controls top rune. Queen of Pain being forced back a little bit there. DD down at bot. Probably going to get taken by Slander, but he is on Broodmother duty. Poor Cheshire Cat. Still a level 2. Here come the sentries. Here comes the DD Slander. Here comes the Tiny rampaging forward. The dust is going to miss, though, and Cheshire Cat back in the trees, so dust wasted by screen. They're not going to catch her. This is the great thing, the Broodmother just staying alive down here. Not under too much pressure while up at the top. There we go. Press the attack with the Mango. Looks like the Legion Commander still in a little bit of trouble. Dive isn't going to be there from Tron, as there's no cask from the Witch Doctor. No additional stun or lockdown to keep him held in place. Look at this. General actually taking the lead in this lane. Are they making stacks just yet? Yeah, they're making a couple of little stacks here for the Tiny. They can go and clear them out pretty nicely. Good block out there. Big knock. Not allowing the pull across from this Legion Commander. So lane equilibrium just going to be held back by the Juggernaut so he can farm freely back here. Cheshire Cat, though, he's at level 3. Two up in the web so he can actually expand his territory over into this Radiant Jungle. Play some Observer Wars down. Watch out for where Slander is moving as well. And then once he gets into level 5, he gets himself into those level 3 spawn spiralings and really makes life a living hell for this Skyrath Mage. Because, okay, early on, Skyrath, you know, good against the Broodmother with all the sentry spammed out. The Arcane Bolt just harassing down as well. Oh, look at that. So bloody annoying. But once Cheshire Cat hits 5, Slander is in a ton of trouble. Actually, here, he could potentially die. You know, all these spiralings around, Cheshire Cat webs out and Slander gets harassed down, but there's the tether. Oh, Courier? It. Keep microing it. Send it back over the tier 1 tower. Keep it safe. Keep it secret. Barash is burnt down by the CMP. General doing an exceptional job. 25 for 18. Demolishing his lane right now against this Queen of Pain. Cheshire Cat. Realizing he can't really do too much down in this bottom lane. Farms through into the jungle. Yeah, for those of you guys tuning in, I think Dota 2 Lounge have taken it down now, but yeah, they put it up as postponed. CIS rejects up against KP has been postponed. Oh, look at that. He tried to get the sentry. D2CL game is not here. I think it's happening on Monday, but I'm not entirely sure. I can't say. Top lane, the wraparound is coming through. J4 and Big Num, they're looking for the kill on the Legion Commander. She's got her press the attack, but she's already basically dead to Tron. He solo kills. First blood 7 minutes into the game. Power Rangers against Big Red Machine. This is just so unusual. Down a bot lane. Oh, here we go. Barash comes in. He's going to get punched down by ZXC, but just catch. Gets a double, and now looking for the triple. ZXC the Titan, he's got toss, but he doesn't have any way of stopping this. Cheshire Cat just charging him down. Soul Ring at the ready. Sports Flathing's there, the toss back, but he can't get through. The chase isn't going to be available. Press the attack, overwhelming odds. The archers hail down the arrows. Force the Broodmother back.
Radiant's top tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
General, what are we going for? Phase boots into Orchid, it looks like. That is magic wand coming out as well. Tron, regular old stats build. Treads Aqua with the magic wand, as well as drums, probably going to fill up that item slot, then into the S and Y. Let's go stock standard. Tron, spin. Time to TP. Time to get the hell away from here. General does a ton of damage. Look at that. With a DD rocket. That's why. He had a DD rocket. That's why. That's what it's up to. So let's swap lanes around a little bit here. With the top tier one dropping. They've put Tiny Wisp up here to try and handle the pressure coming out from this Juggernaut. And Legion Commander getting some free farm time down the bottom lane. So Tiny with 2,000 gold saved up. It looks like he's going to go in for Blink Dagger first and play a little more aggressively, jumping himself around. Now toss in the Legion Commander, blink yourself forward as well, and get that two-pronged attack while Slander. Still struggling to get into his level 6, sitting around level 4.5. Gonna kill off the Queen of Pain though. Ancient Seal, up to level 1 only. Tornado EMP gonna be off the mark completely. Barash could potentially turn a fight this. Sonic Wave for 20 seconds, still on cooldown. Can't get the kill back onto the Scarath Mage, but that's a complete fumble. General missing out on that perfect combo. Barash is still definitely being bullied here. Vocal level 8, Quop level 7. But the net worth is where you'll see it. A good 500 or 400 difference there between the Quop and that Invoker. Once this General Invoker gets his Orchid up, Queen of Pain is going to be bullied even more. Big Num. He's forcing the Legion back into a position where Barash is getting ready to fight, but half HP, 260 mana. You've only got enough for one Sonic Wave and that's it. Rune Control, going all the way to BRM, honestly. Bounty up at top, going to be taken up here by General, more likely than not. But the Queen of Pain, has she had a single rune all game long? It's been so rough for her. There's your first Oblivion Staff for Cheshire Cat, though. He's building into an Orchid of his own. J4 with 1,500 gold. What's he saving up for? Going by Arcane Boots, going by an Urn, by a Midas Recipe, by a Point Booster. Going straight into the axe. At least he's going to go for the value stats. The jump forward, I should have seen that coming. Apologies, guys. A little bit of a brain fart. That Blink Dagger debut, ZXC. Makes full use of it. Big Num trying to get his level 6. He's got it now. 3, 4, 5, 6, yep. Interesting that he's holding onto that skill point as Tron is dueled up here. Slowed by the concussive. And Juggernaut should be dead. Even with the relocate forward, Screen was desperate. Hungry for that kill. 3-3, and Big Red Machine actually looking pretty hot. They've got full lane control. Power Rangers, the Broodmother is like the one saving grace for them. Tron, this Juggernaut, he is lagging behind now. In terms of progression, you know, his net worth is still up at the top, but actual fighting power, Barash is dead. The counter will fly. BRM, taking full control of the map, and this is the thing, the Juggernaut, he's level 8. With this defensive trial lane they had, they've limited the farm, really, on the Juggernaut. The Witch Doctor and Wyvern, fair enough, they've got themselves a decent amount.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Got everything in moderation.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Tier 1, General, try and deny it. spiderlings flying around. Tornadoes out as well. And this should be a simple tonight. Just clear out the spiderlings, get the tower hits in. Make sure that the bloody broodmother doesn't kill it off. Rotation through the jungle, though. They want to come onto the broodmother lane. They want to gank into this. Sentry Ward will scout out the brood. General is here and he sees them with a cold snap at the ready. Oh god, they walk straight in. Slander stances up Tron and now with his curse on the general. Death Ward's there with a sonic wave across. Barash makes freaking sure that that bloody invoker is dead. The hatred is real. Barash, he wanted to kill invoker. He wanted general deep. Deep in his grave. Is under attack.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
ZXC 1500. So, I wonder if he goes for drums in the first place and then goes into the Aghanim Scepter. Well, they're going to relocate down to bottom lane and look for big numbers. Avalanche toss with a blink as well. Cool embrace doesn't save you from that, my friend. Cheshire Cat running himself backwards and forwards looking for something, but honestly, they're just going to relocate themselves back up to top. There's nothing stopping them. Up the top lane is Tron. Tron the Juggernaut, who maybe is in trouble here. ZXC has enough mana for... if he switches to intreads, I guess he's got mana for combo, but spiraling money. Fully in there for that Legion Commander. Cheshire Cat. Tornado, but no EMP. Slow down a little bit.
Dire's top tower is
the Dire definitely, they want things to slow down. They want to farm. Now, Radiant with their Wisp Tiny, they wouldn't be adverse to farming as well. And what do we actually see? What's Tiny picked up? He's... this is Curse. Legion Commander's dead with a Death Ward as well. Triple ulti expended. But yeah, he's going straight into the Aghanim Scepter. No reason to go for the drums. But Power Rangers, they don't need to farm for too long. They need to farm for like the next 5 minutes or so. Get yourself a good amount of farm on Tron. Get him up to level 11, I think, is one of the key points here. Definitely general. Oh, no Orchid. Orcs in. Spins out from Tron. So back to safety. They want level 11 on Juggernaut. I don't think there's a key item he needs. It's just stats and level 11. Queen of Pain, you're nowhere near a big item. You just want level 11 yourself. Winter Wyvern, you don't care about items. And Broodmother, you want the Orchid, which is done. So they are basically... two levels on two heroes away from going to fight and potentially win fights. Whereas Radiant,
top tower is
they need
attack.
Blink on the Legion Commander or a Shadow Blade. They Dire's need the Aghanim Scepter up on Tiny, which is halfway towards, and they need the Orchid on the Invoker. So there are definitely some big key items that the Radiant are missing here, whereas Power Rangers missing levels. Big numbers. Oh god, Cold Snap. This should secure him. Can't turn and kill, maybe not. In comes the Omni Slash. Legion Commander's trying to run himself away, but the Blade Fury is there. Big Numb will die to the Avalanche out for Tiny. Slander in the middle of them all. A toss back onto Tron. Barash is burning down. His HP pool, not that hot. But the Wisp will relocate away. Oh, the cast! Broodmother comes in. ZXC trapped here with the Death Ward, pounding him into the ground. And Arcade Power Rangers. If they wanted level 11, they freaking well got it. Queen of Pain's going to miss out a little bit on that one. Up at top, the split push is coming in from Screen the Wisp. Not exactly what you're expecting, but a good 2,300 or so gold swing. About 2,500 net worth. Oh my god. Experience swing. I'm sorry. It's been a long day. It's been a long one. I've been up since like 6 in the morning, but we're getting through it. We're getting through it. My brain is just starting to forget what words mean. Tron's got himself a full Yash completed over on the old courier. Well, it's phase boots for Cheshire Cat, so Orchid phase boots, your broodmother, 402. And you remember the start she had, the Sentry Ward Wars. The 10-year war, just Sentry Wards being spammed everywhere. And now, closing the gap. ZXC needs his Aghanim Scepter, and he's 1300 away from that, so time to get... time to knuckle down and start farming. Really, really concentrate on that farm. Same with the Legion Commander. Broodmother's on the hunt. General has Orchid. Cheshire Cat has Orchid. Whose Orchid is going to be more potent? Looks like General wants to TP up and try and bait this Legion Commander into something. Slander. Slander. Be careful with your positioning. Is this a smoke up from Power Rangers? Let's go. It's like they're pinging out Roshan. With the Spiderlings, they could potentially go and take it. And at this point, they're going to walk themselves through the jungle. They know that the Tiny's farming Aghanim somewhere. And if it's not over here, it's not mid, it's not top, it's got to be this camp. Oh, the blink away. They catch screen, they get the wisp. Not really the target they were looking for, but still. It's a kill. A kill's a kill. General, Ghost walked up, still looking for a target. Maybe Big Numbers, what are you looking for? But the rest of Power Rangers, they're all here. Deep Tornado. Get the Orchid out, the blink forward though, Ghost walk away. General, quick on his fingers there.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
And it looks like it should be a quick and easy rockstar. Healing wards, fire things.
Is under attack.
Slander has hit level 6 finally. ZXC has his Aghanim Scepter in 20 gold. Just go and farm a creep wave. Kill it off. Finish it. Get your ags. Done and dusted. Blink Dagger 450 away from your Legion. But with DD Rune up on the Queen of Pain, it's expiring soon, so I guess it's not too bad, but.
Dire's top tower is under
Aegis
attack.
On Tier 2's definitely going to be the target here from Power Rangers as Broodmother. Full control of the Radiant Jungle for the past, you know, 7 or 8 minutes or so. It's difficult for General to go and find a target. This Invoker would love to go and pick off Big Num, go and kill the Queen of Pain, go and just burst people down. But with the way that Power Rangers are grouping up and, you know, look at this. Three heroes all in like the Bermuda Triangle of Destruction, waiting for someone to come along. Then Tron. He's got Aegis. You can't go and pick him off. Cheshire Cat's a broodmother, hiding away in the bloody spiderling webs. General does have a dust, though. If you get wind of this Cheshire Cat brood, pop the dust, kill her off. Yeah. Once again, though, we're seeing this Queen of Pain really lagging behind in the farm. Varash, for the second game running, is getting a post-20-minute Aghanim Scepter. He got completely crushed by General at mid. 1, 2, and 5. And 1,000 gold away. Still, from that Ags. Need to get a few kills under his belt. Get him a couple of kill streaks. The Tiny's 5-1. Kill him off, take him down. He's killing his ranges pretty nicely with that Aghanim's up now. And this is where the danger zone really is. If Power Rangers lose this next fight, it's where Big Red Machine could go and split push. Take tier 1s, take tier 2s, and really assert their dominance on the map. But it looks like Slander's going to be the pickoff. Again, they're going to go for the easy support kill, which is kind of surprising. They're not going for these big, easy targets. The EMP is going to slow them down and burn through their mana, but it's not really going to stop them killing off that Skyrath Mage or General. Oh, they nearly had him! That was super close. Make full use of this Aegis though.
Radiant's
still up for another couple of minutes or so. 2 minutes and 10 seconds. Just easily take tier 2s. Glyph not even worth it for this tower, honestly. They want to save it for mid-tier 2.
Bottom tower has fallen.
Top tier 2 might be the push plan from Power Rangers. Go mid, shove mid-wave, and then push top tier 2 with the TP from Jug. I'm pretty sure Jug TP's top. Pushes this. They have 4 people push this, and then they rotate through their own jungle. That's going to be Big Num. Okay.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, Broodmother's farming down at bottom lane. There we go. That's what I wanted. So it was just defensive posturing, making sure the Big Num is going to be there to defend. But yeah, Juggernaut farms top. They have a couple of heroes pushed mid. And they move towards this tier 2 up at top. And that's basically just because top tier 2 is a lot more difficult to defend than the mid tier 2. Because here for Power Rangers, you know... Wait a second. Just a cat? He's okay. He's fine. Basically here, you know, there's so many wraparound options to actually come in from that it's harder for Big Red Machine just to, you know, group up here and hard push towards the enemy. Whereas here, you know, they can push themselves out across. They can come in from this side. There's just so many more avenues for them. All screen. Another support kill. Easy takedown. No buyback. But yeah, it's much easier for the Dire to take the top tier 2. Is basically it. And then once they've taken this, if they get a couple of kills, they can move themselves across. Take creep wave and then go back into the enemy jungle. This is the thing, the Broodmother has full control here. They are limiting the farm so heavily of ZXC. At the time, you can't really do anything. Tornado EMP, annoying. There's the Manta from Tron. He doesn't spin in time though to try and mitigate that mana loss, but he's got Aegis. He doesn't really care too much. If he dies here, he's perfectly happy with it. Cold Embrace heals him up. General goes forward with a healing ward kill. Well, Tron is actually forced back with the Arcane Bolt spams out. Wisp Tiny, where are you going to go? Do you want to kill the Broodmother, do you? Well, the Broodmother doesn't want to be killed. Where the hell are we? Yup. Does Witch Doctor have it? Whose is this? Come on. Come on. So this is Witch Doctor's. These are Witch Doctor's. And... the fuck is this? I'm not sure what that's about. Cheshire Cat's gonna get dueled up. He's actually life-stealing through this. The duel, it's not gonna be won. And Cheshire Cat, oh, nearly gets away, but finally Legion gets that dominating streak away from that damn little Broodmother. Up at top, Tron can Manta and get the spin-off as well. General on the retreat out, goes walking available, but in comes Quab, not quite in time. But I don't know what the hell that relocate was. Screen was under the effect of spawn spiraling, so I guess the Broodmother went on screen and he just panic relocated somewhere? Interesting stuff, though. Interesting stuff.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, they kill the Brood.
Structures are fortified.
They stem the bleeding a little bit. Now they're looking to try and take the tier 1, but the Scream Sonic Wave screen! Screen! Winter's Curse, perfect placement. Cast bounce back and the Omni Slash to finish. Tiny Wisp dead. And what are they getting on the rebound? Absolutely nothing. A bit of farm in the enemy jungle. They're not. Split pushing heavily up at top. They do have the blink and 2100 gold on the Legion Commander, though. General, he's got himself Midas after the Orchid, so he's actually aiming himself towards the later game. But level 11 Aghanim upgraded Witch Doctor Ultimate is here for J4. Winter's Curse, 80 seconds cooldown for that one. BKB nearly there for the Broodmother. I've just got this feeling. Power Rangers with this 7,500 net worth lead. Same in experience. It is so difficult for BRM to hold their own in this game. To actually win team fights, to do anything. Like, finding pickoffs is impossible for this Invoker. He's 1-2-2. That kill he got was like 3 minutes in. But anything's possible with the Tiny Wisp. Anything's possible. They can split push. They can backdoor. They can take racks. They can go and kill stuff. And now with a gem on the Invoker. Okay, that's going to open up avenues that we just haven't seen yet. That Broodmother's got to be very careful with her positioning. But you've got J4 behind you with Big Num as well, just waiting in the wings. Well, they see Cheshire Cat. Aegis. Roshan respawns now. Relocate forward. The gem reveal. Avatos. Oh, BKB's there for Cheshire Cat. Oh, he's still going to get tossed up at the Death Ward. Bouncing back between them. Oh, he's going to kill off the Wisp. And Juggernaut takes down the Legion Commander up at top. ZXC as well as General will escape. Lose the Broodmother for 2 in exchange. But I think that's worth it. That's worth it for BRM. They're stopping the Roshan. They're stopping this incessant push down in the bottom lane. And what, they lose their Legion Commander? Did Tron get my... Oh god, Tron got some damage. Like, the Wisp is just a throwaway kill at this point. Legion Commander, okay, it's collateral damage, but killing the Broodmother is fully worth it there. Getting some kind of kill over on this Invoker as well, definitely. Barash, do you have people to save you? Cold Embraces, Glimmer Cape. Yep, you should be safe. General, Alacrity. For that 1 point in Exort. Look at that perfect rune for Queen of Pain. Wait, where's she gone? Did she go back to base? Pain. No! There's a regen rune there for you. Oh, well, got it up for her. ZXC. The style nearly done. Attack. Fully necessary against this Broodmother Orchid, definitely. You could go for BKB, but against Death Ward, Winter's Curse, Omni Slash, the Mana Style gives more targets for the Omni Slash, which gets you out of Orchid. And also, you know, Winter's Curse, not blocked by the BKB. So, perfect item choice, I think, for him. On top of the fact it gives you agility, attack speed and armor. Two things that Tiny desperately, desperately needs. But I'm not sure that they can contest this Roche Pit. General's nowhere near ready for it. Slander, nope. He can't get in there either. These supports are pretty poor. The Wisp and the Scars Mage. Nothing to their names, like the Scars running around with a magic wand and observer wards. Mass TP's up the top to defend this tier 2. We're going to wait for the jump forward from Barash and TP onto this tier 2. Glyph is there. Fortified. Barash, I think, has shown himself, though. Slander's over to the side. Tornado. Not going to catch anybody. And the tower. It's going to be denied. Damn, Witch Doctor. Top tower there we have it. Broodmother. Oh, this is a target. This is what they want. The general TP's down to bottom lane. He's still got that gem. Looking for Cheshire Cat's Brood. But BKB gem up on the Broodmother as well. Got to remember that. Got to look for this. Dire Sentry will scout out General if he walks this way. There's no vision. They'll see him now. Oh, Cheshire Cat. Be careful, man. General knows what he wants. And it's Spider Blood. Duel onto Big Num here. Ah, with the Relocate forward. Okay, they're going to secure this kill. No damage. Out. J4, the cast bouncing back and forth. Death Ward, no, not even needed. Maledict's out with the Omni Slash as well. Tron. Wait. Wait, what? Well, bottom lane general, silenced up. He could try and ghost walk, but he's already dead. Screwed over by the Broodmother. And she's got double gem. A gem of her own and the one that General was holding to try and catch her. It's just. They're both hunting each other, but Broodmother came out on top because of that BKB that she's picked
Radiant's
herself up.
Middle tower
on top
is under
of
attack.
The 1200 gold she's got. It's just slowly but surely, securing this game. Power Rangers. They're clearing it up. Tron with a new Aegis, Skadi Manta style. On to the tier 3s. Glyph is here. Tiny, Wisp alive. Invoke is still dead for 25 seconds. This is a make or break moment though, really, for them. The Broodmother gonna be split pushing down a bottom lane. Needs to make Spiderlings. Cheshire Cat, there we go. Get yourself along with that, Tron. Up on the front lines. Omni Slash down for 35 seconds though. ZXC tries to get into the thick of things. Avatos expended as the jewel comes out to Barash. But that Mystic Flare, Winter's Curse has it back in the Death Ward, bouncing back onto them, but it doesn't do that much damage with that mitigation of 70%. But they're going to relocate themselves out. Splinter Blast kills off the Wisp on the back end, and the Tornado EMP will force the BKB out of Cheshire Cat. Nope, still dead. Geometry side dropped on the ground as General. Not going to pick it up, but the racks have fallen. They're losing out in the long run. The gem gets picked up by the Wait, did it? No, it got picked up by Tiny. Tiny gets it. And there's still an Aegis on Tron. The Juggernaut has Omni Slash ready now. And Barash has Sonic Wave as well. So they could just run themselves into the team fight if they wanted to. They just want the tier 3s. They've taken down the melee ranks of mid. Looking for the naked racks down the bottom lane now. Glyph is popped. But there are three heroes dead for a decent amount of time. General, Tornado EMP, slow down the push. Orchid is there, but the spin of the Magistar. Lance toss, Tiny goes on to J4, but he doesn't finish him off. Arctic Burn slows him down. Ominous Slash here. ZXC ripped apart. Gem is on the deck, and there's that Sonic Wave from Barash. Tiny has a buyback, though, and they might want to bait this one out. Tron still has the Aegis. Still has it for another minute and a half or so. Yeah, minute 15, minute 20 seconds. Aghanim Scepter upgrade. He's still only level 17 though. I think it's level 19 that you get the AoE Deafening Blast. I can't quite remember. Something along those lines. Or maybe that's level 19 with 2 points, maybe. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. He needs more levels. He definitely needs more levels. Cheshire Cat. Yep. What are you going to be buying? Boots of Travel. Interesting. Phase Boots and Boots of Travel. Barash? You are relatively alone here. Slander, TP's out. Oh god, the Sonic Wave is there. Clears up the Scarath Mage. And Tiny just walks it off. Legion Commander should be okay, just to run down as well. But General, having so many difficulties with this Cheshire Cat Broodmother. Orchid. Run to Cheshire Cat. There's no gem. There we go. Gem is picked back up by the Broodmother. They go from here. One lane racks down. Tiny Wisp, you know, they're never out. Never out of contention. They are split push kings along with Nature's Prophet. But they're dealing with a 20,000 net worth deficit right now. Power Rangers. And their item progression has slowed significantly. A Basher now up on Tron. Not amazing. He needs his Abyssal Blade. He needs to get into the thick of things. And speaking of, J4, your Death Ward is available. The Winter's Curse is good. Sonic Wave across the bridge as well. And ZXC Alacrity pounding into Cheshire Cat. But J4, Death Ward has already been used, actually, as Big Num. Thrown, tossed, and stunned. The duel comes in for easy damage. But Omni Slash will clean that on up. A Screen Slander and ZXC all on the run. Retreating out. J4 wants to cast with his Blink forward. He's not going to find it. Look at Slander. They'll slow him up and kill him off. Cheshire Cat dies to the Mystic Flare, but you've got buyback on both Invoker and your Legion Commander. Legion Commander, 28 damage gained from this game. 36 minutes in. Not amazing, I've got to say. Not amazing. Force buybacks. Looks like it. Glyph not available. I think Legion has to buy back. Generally, you want to kind of hold on to. The mid split push in. They come with the Glyph, though. Gonna stop that advance. ZXC going to struggle to take the tier 3. As their bot racks are gone. Forfeit. TP is coming back now. Yeah, defend his tier 3. Screen on the back end. He can't relocate save. The Death Ward is down. ZXC is already screwed. Screen relocates himself away, but he's going to relocate straight back into death. And at this point, Big Red Machine, you've tried your hardest. And yeah, it's level 25, but he's got Ags upgrade. So it's minus 3. And I'm thinking of level 2 invoke. The fastest you can get it is level 19, I'm pretty sure, with Ags. For the AoE Deafening Blast. Tiny Back up in 15. Oh, they wanted the blink initiation there on the clock. Not gonna find it. And yeah, for those of you guys looking for the KP versus CIS Rejects game, postponed and maybe on Monday. I'm not too sure yet. There's not been a scheduled date or time for it just yet. Right, here we go. Hardcore push in. J4, level 17. Death Ward. Fully upgraded. Strong on the front line. Yeah, a bit risky doing this one. Blade Fury to take down the tower. He's got no Aegis. He's got Panda Style and Scardy. So you can tank through a ton. BKB. Duel is here. And he'll Sonic Wave with a Mystic Flare. And I'll actually throw it out there. Death Ward is down as J4 comes in from the back. They've crushed them all. J4 demolishes the entirety of BRM. And GG is cold. Power Rangers, they find themselves with 1,500 euros in their pockets. Big Red Machine, Screen Squad, 500. 100 euros apiece. GG. Well played, both teams. Getting themselves through to the grand final. But a 2-0 win here from Power Rangers gets them the victory. And that's it for tonight. It's been a good one. Now, it's kind of unfortunate seeing Screen Squad not able to play, you know, that aggressive style, but Power Rangers had their number. All throughout the bracket, Screen Squad were playing like aggro tri-lanes with Tusk and Undying and just running at people. Power Rangers banned the Tusk and all of a sudden, BRM, you know, trying to fall back on different strats, give General Invoker. I mean, his Shadow Fiend and his Queen of Pain play were massively impressive in the previous games, but it just wasn't to be. Congrats, Power Rangers. That's it for tonight. Thanks for watching, guys. I've been Durka. You can check me out on Twitter and Facebook at DurkaDota. That's good night. Enjoy the rest of your evening. And make sure to tune in. I'm pretty sure Toby and I will be streaming, but we're going to have a joinDOTA Staff Cup tomorrow. So internal Staff Cup with all the JD admins and editorial crew. But I'll be streaming over on Twitch/DurkaDota. Toby Wan, I think, is going to be streaming over on... Is he Toby Wan or Toby Wan Dota? Or just Toby? I can't remember. He's changed his name so many bloody times. But yeah, good night, guys. Tune into our Twitch channels tomorrow. See you next time.